What kind of girls do you prefer?
My wife.
Your wife. What kind of girl is she?
She's a nice girl.
What kind of girl do you like?
John's wife.
Lennon is definitely an icon who does not need an introduction. He was the founder and co-vocalist of the band The Beatles. Born in Liverpool, Lennon's first band evolved into The Beatles in 1960. Over the course of his career, Lennon had 25 hit singles and was inducted into the Hall of Fame in 1997. He was also in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame twice. In 1973, Lennon and Yoko Ono moved to the Dakota Apartments located in New York City. Ironically, they required a more secure complex to live in. Tragically, Lennon was actually murdered in the archway on December 8th, 1980 by Mark David Chapman. 5 shots were fired by Chapman, 4 hit Lennon in the back. He was pronounced dead upon arrival at the Roosevelt Hospital. The world felt the gravity of Lennon's death instantaneously. Crowds gathered in the front of the Dakota and hosted vigils. Given my niche on YouTube on this 40th year anniversary, I would like to share the history of the Dakota Apartments. Located on 72nd Street and Central Park West, the Dakota Buildings was constructed in a Gothic style and was home to incredibly famous celebrities like Julie Garland, Roberta Flack, and of course John Lennon, just to name a few. On this 40th anniversary of his passing, I would like to dedicate this video to Beatles fans everywhere and of course my number one supporter, my mom. John Lennon was the first love of her life. Hey guys, it is your girl Nat here, and I have a brand new video today. Very exciting. Send it to a John Lennon fan, and we'll just get right into it. If you are new here, my name is Natalie Perry. I am a graduate from Ohio State. I am a current Master's of Architecture candidate at University of Pennsylvania, and the purpose of this channel is just to unravel the complex world of architecture for you all. So subscribe if you're interested in content like this. It really helps me out, and give this a big thumbs up. Let's just get right into it. The Dakota has been referred to as the most famous apartment building in New York City. Completed in 1884, New York City sprouted up around this iconic building. In 1880, the founder of Singer Sewing Machine Company, Edward Clark, commissioned the building. It was architect Henry Janeway Hardenberg who designed the plaza, later on created the Dakota Apartment Building. The commission was $1 million, which is the equivalent to $25 million today. However, that still probably wouldn't be the correct build price, given the fact that to buy an apartment in the Dakota sometimes costs over $25 million today. This design spawned the development of the empty Upper West Side. Clark had a vision to create an upscale suburb in New York City, but the Dakota was building block number one. Even the Dakota's name is commentary on the apartment's distance from the busy streets of New York City. People would refer to the apartment building saying it might as well have been out west in the Dakotas. Programmatically speaking, there are 65 apartments where every single one has been uniquely designed. The idea of luxury apartments was still quite novel for its time. Single-family living dominated residential architecture. But in order to make tenement lifestyle less tenement-like, breaking the stigma and reputation, these apartments are absolutely extraordinary. All apartments come with amenities seen in private mansions. Some even have 16 rooms total. Style-wise, in the intro, I mentioned it had a sort of Gothic style. However, there's mixed vocabulary. There's hint of German Renaissance architecture, Chateauesque architecture, blended with a Gothic revival style, all perfectly mixed together to create this eclectic building. Structurally speaking, the building proposal submission presented more like a fortress than an apartment complex. It is not constructed in a, quote, new method of structures using steel framework. Instead, it used iron beams with concrete for the flooring. The foundation is about 3 to 4 feet thick, which is actually uncomfortably thick for a slab. There is an interior courtyard originally intended for residents to exit horse-drawn carriages in style. Also, this courtyard granted privacy. Natural lighting was guided into the apartments, and it also promoted better ventilation. There is a basement for, quote, domestic workers, carved underneath this courtyard. The yellow brick is trimmed with a beautiful Nova Scotia freestone and terracotta spandrels. There are bay and octagon windows and detailed balconies with balustrades. The architect, Henry Hardenborough, did not include fire escapes. He took mud, literal mud, from Central Park and slathered it between layers of masonry brick flooring to fireproof and soundproof the building. Other features. Other materials used to build the Dakota include beautiful bronze staircases, rare marble wall treatments, four innovative and luxurious elevators. They also built an in-house power plant, and its boilers could literally heat every single structure in New York in a 4-block radius. That's crazy, guys. Like, that is literally insane. Edward Clark requested sterling silver floors. However, Clark died in 1882, 2 full years before the building could ever be completed. Since it opened in 1884, the super rich have been drawn to the Dakota. The Steinway family of the Steinway Piano Company were the first residents there. Today, famous are still drawn to the Dakota like a magnet. Even elite celebrities have had their applications rejected. The application process just to live there is absolutely insane. Just the application fee itself is $1,000. Cher, Billy Joel, Madonna, and so many others have actually been rejected by this Dakota co-op board. To this day, Yoko Ono still resides in the Dakota Apartments. And this is, in fact, the same apartment that Yoko and John shared. She even claimed once after John's death that she saw his ghost in the Dakota apartment. She saw her husband's ghost sitting at his white piano. This is based on an interview by the New York Post. So as always, I'm going to have my sources linked down below. Please go check them out. I would love to hear from you guys and Beatles fans everywhere. I know today is a definitely heavy day, given that it has been 40 years since his passing. And I hope you learned something new and exciting about the Dakota Apartments. I always grew up listening to the Beatles because my mom is absolutely obsessed, and especially with John Lennon. Very grateful that I have a good music taste today. That is it for today's video. Once again, please hit the subscribe button. It helps me out a lot. And I hope to see you next time. Love you guys.